This is the first full day of the trial of Charles Darnell and Jaron Hare. In opening arguments, the state set the scene that Jaron's daughter, 2-year-old Cheyenne, was living in a home with a dangerous 8-foot albino python, a python kept in a mesh laundry bag inside an aquarium, and that around July 1st, 2009, the pet python escaped, slithered into Cheyenne's crib, bit her multiple times, then strangled her to death.
And although that albino Burmese python is the instrument of death, those two defendants are responsible for the death of Cheyenne Hare.
The attorney for Jaron Hare told the jury his client was only 19, uneducated, and that the defendant's mother bought the python at a flea market as a pet when she was only 14 years old. Jaron Hare grew up with the python, took it for rides in the family car.
But the snake was always out, ladies and gentlemen. The snake was out. It was a pet. Like having a pit bull in the house. And all of a sudden, the pit bull goes crazy.
Charles Darnell's attorney tried to distance her client from the child's mother, told the jury he was not the child's father, not the owner of the python, and it was an accident they did not see coming.
An unexpected, unintentional accident that resulted in death.
As evidence, the state wheeled in Cheyenne's crib, the crib she was found dead in, and the python's home, a large aquarium with a quilt on top. Now, Gypsy the python is still alive, but the state prosecutor indicated he is not going to bring that snake into court as evidence because he did not want to create what he called a media circus. Live in Sumter County, Michelle Meredith, WESH 2 News.